You bet. The displeasing revelation came to light as the committee interfaced with and grilled the National Lotteries and Gaming Regulatory Board top officials who appeared to respond to queries raised in the Auditor General's report for the financial year 2021-2022. The acting chief executive officer of the National Lotteries and Gaming Regulatory Board, Dennis Ngabirano, confessed that his entity has been regulating the gaming sector for years without the requisite standards in place.
One, you're saying the process has taken long, because what are you regulating that you don't know? That's part of the challenge, because if you don't have a register, you're relying on those you're licensing to have a register. So that means whoever does not come to you for a license, you don't know about them. They're doing whatever it is they want to do, because I would have expected that you people have a proper register by which you work.
But yes, it is true. At the moment, UNBS cannot test and certify gaming equipment. The law, the Lotteries and Gaming Act, provides the pre-qualification of independent testing laboratories. And these laboratories are known world over. And we, in 2018, did a pre-qualification of these independent laboratories. And when they set shop here, like I explained, that's why they told us the standards earlier adopted in 2017, which were the SANS standard, the South African national standards. We are speaking to the South African law.
Because I brought one my 1000, and then this machine is not set, it is not calibrated, somehow it gives me a false result. How do you guard against that if these softwares are not, you know, tested and what? And approved.
In pressing questions to the board, the committee chairperson Joel Senyonyi tasked gaming regulators in Uganda to explain circumstances under which they enforce and plow sanity in the sector whose machines operate without a minimum to regulate them.
A bigger concern now is the standards which you're saying have not been approved, because these machines are all over the place. We are not sure. They must be cheating many Ugandans. People go there excited, I'm going to get rich. They come out poorer. Meanwhile, some Chinese or whoever, the investor, is becoming richer.
A section of members of parliament on the committee, including Bokoto's Central's Richard Sebamala, recommended that the gambling business be put on hold until minimum standards are put in place.
So what we need to do actually is to stop the betting business in those for as long as we don't have the standards and the software is not approved. Otherwise, people are just being cheated.
In defense, the board attributed the anomaly to Uganda's standards body, the Uganda National Bureau of Standards, that has delayed to approve the 14 standards which they submitted for verification in 2021. They added that even UNBS has no technology capacity to test and certify gaming equipment.
UNBS, yes, the law mandates us to set standards in consultation with UNBS. And as the board, we have developed 14 technical standards. These were submitted to UNBS. They were taken through the process of standards approval, which include public reviews. And at the moment, they are before the UNBS Council for approval.
He therefore begged that the committee uses its powers to compel the line ministry and standards body to approve and enact the said standards.
So until these standards are approved, we can't do much as a gaming board. What we are confiscating is for the illegals. For the substandards, we can't do much until we have these standards in place.
You have been engaging the ED of UNBS. At that level, nothing is happening. I'm wondering why you had not escalated this, because maybe at ministerial level, the minister in charge of your entity engages the minister in charge of UNBS, who is the one for trade, and at that level they fix this issue.
The comment went on to indicate that the initial set of standards that had been put in place were overly aligned to the South African legal system and therefore unsuitable for the Ugandan context, which therefore demanded that a fresh set of standards be generated and implemented. In the financial year that ended June 2022, the National Lotteries and Gaming Regulatory Board confiscated 1,148 illegal betting devices despite the absence of minimum standards. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.